If the first human beings were African, they would have African names, not Arabic ones, or Hebrew ones, or Chinese ones, or Japanese ones, wouldn't they? They would have African names, wouldn't they? The first man would have an African name because he's African, yes or no? Okay, so is Adam an African name?
Origin of African's name, African names, originated. Origin African names, originated.
Africans did.
African when?
Whenever they existed.
And what was it like? Oh, you know, Adam was the one.
I'll tell you what I do know. The name Adam is from the Hebrew language. That's what
Adam would have sung it. Adam.
Listen, it doesn't matter. The name Adam is not from the Japanese language, is it?
So it's a possible.
Hang on. Is the name Adam from Japan?
No.
No, it's not, is it? Is the name Adam from Hebrew?
Is it possible?
I'm asking you, is the name Adam from Hebrew?
Yeah.
Okay, so were the Hebrews the first people?
So I'm asking you now.
Hang on, were the Hebrews the first people? No. Africans were. So how now can an African be run around with a Hebrew name when an African existed 100,000 years before the Hebrew language even existed?
I said the first source is the Quran. For you to override that, you bring me something else.
Let me.
I can bring in the Quran and tell what it says about the water cycle. When the Greek and the Roman and before that, and Democritus, and they're all getting it wrong.
Let me tell you something.
For you to say the burden is on you, I don't need hypothetical from you. Give me a source. Give me a source. Give me a source of certainty.
No,
I'm asking you. Give me a source.
That's the biggest hypothetical going.
No.
Give me a source.
That's the biggest hypothetical going. That explain the water cycle. You don't have it. But I can give you the Quran.
Okay.
And I'm predicting.
Give me a source.
That's the evidence that shows me.
Wait.
Let's go.
Give me a source that shows me, that shows everyone how to build the pyramids.
Yeah, where's the...
Give me a source.
Thank you.
That shows me how to build the pyramids of Giza, aligned with Orion's belt, 20 ton, 40 ton, 50 ton blocks on top of one another, within a centimeter of one another, starting no cement with the tools that they had 6,000 years ago. Bring me the source to show me how they did that.
I can give you the source.
Really?
God.
No, you see what I'm saying? Bro, you don't understand how crazy you sound, you know? Let me tell you something. You can't even prove God, but you're going to give me God as a source. What are you talking about?
The pyramid.
Come on, you can't insert God. Listen, bro.
He complements this building. Come on, talk about it as well.
Brother, you cannot insert God into an equation that you can't understand.
Do you know
who built
the pyramid? I don't even know who built it. Do you know who built it? I know who built it, but you don't even know who built it. You're talking. Do you know who built it?
You know God built the pyramid.
Do you know who built it?
The Africans that built it.
Oh, give me his name.
I don't know them.
Give me the lead construction name.
Minanua?
That's the problem with you. So you should learn something. You see, you don't have this knowledge. That's the problem with you.
My friend.
I have his name, but you don't even know his name.
You have the guy's name?
Yes.
Okay.
I never see her.
Right.
I never met her.
Right.
She's anonymous to me.
Right.
I don't know what I think about her.
Right.
But I'm 100% sure she exists.
Why?
Are you disagreeing with that?
No. But why do you know that?
Because you see, like, no,
exactly. And I said, you know, and without my mother, I could not exist, right?
Go. Are you not sure that the creator of the universe exists?
Like I say, I don't know. Just like you know. Hang on. Listen. Just like you know my mother exists because I did.
So you exist.
Because I don't just pop into existence for nothing, do I?
So then,
I don't, do I?
I like that plan.
I don't, do I?
I agree with you.
I do not pop into existence.
I agree with you.
However,
what about the universe? The universe exists?
The universe exists.
Yeah.
Yes. Of course it does.
Yeah, so that doesn't pop into being like
that. I never said it did.
But the Bible that you have.
So I show your mother exists because you don't pop into being. I show your mother exists because you don't pop into being.
Right.
So but I cannot use the same line for the universe. You know, the spirit of the universe exists because the universe didn't just pop into being.
My friend.
Same line of argument.
My friend.
Don't understand that same line of argument.
No, I am telling you a total line of argument. What I'm trying to say to you is people's theories now. Theories. I'm not even running from it. People's theories. Hang on. My mother isn't a theory, my friend. My mother and father are not theories.
I'm not saying theories.
No, but I'm trying to say to you, many people all over the globe have said the creator of the universe is X.
The only fuck.
Wait. Listen to what I'm trying to say to you.
Yeah,
the Muslims say it was Allah. The Jews say it was Jehovah. Yeah. Whoever says it was whoever. No, but this is what I'm trying to say to you. All I know.
I'm not. Yeah, that's a little earlier.
My friend, you asked me if I know a creator exists. Yeah. That's what you asked me.
Said it for earlier.
But you asked me. if I know a crater exists. Did you ask me that question?
Before I met you right here, you could say before, you might, it would be a theory to me, don't it? Because before you were here.
No, because you're smart enough.
Eh?
You're smart enough to know.
But I didn't know you, I never see you. You might, it would be a theory to me, just to be like,
friend,
here.
But you're smart enough to know that nothing popped into existence.
When I see you right here,
Jesus, the son of Mary.
When I see you right here, like I said
before him,
your mother is anonymous to me, your beloved mother. I don't know her, but I have respect for you, so I respect for your mother.
Confirming the Torah that had came before.
But 100% I can back that your mother, that lady,
right?
Because I see you here.
I will agree with
you. I never see you.
I will agree with you.
So I'm asking you now.
Yes.
In the Quran, God says, no one God says, contemplate on the creation.
Luke, Job.
All of them.
What is the Quran?
You get to know. You get to know.
You just mentioned something. What is the Quran?
My point is, if you agree that first logic, and I don't know, it's the same logic.
No. It's not. What is the Quran?
Does universe exist?
Wait.
Yes, of
course it does.
No.
What did you say? You said in the Quran. I said to you, what is the Quran? Have you proven that? I'm not running from anything, my friend. What I'm trying to say to you is, many people claim many things. The Jews claim that the Jews claim Jehovah is the creator of the universe. You claim Allah's creator of the universe. My friend over there says X is the creator of the universe. She says X is the creator of the universe. I'm saying to you, many people claim that the creator of the universe is X, but none of you have been found.
Is it that you misunderstood? Are you the sincere today? And what you understood a while ago, you eyed it a while ago. That's the second stage of giving identity. Like I said to you, I don't know your mother's name. She's still anonymous to me.
Right.
But I still can bank 100% she exists. I can put my life on that, man.
Right, because
you exist, and I don't know. I never met her. I never see her.
I agree with you.
So that's the step. I'm all at a junction. So I'm saying, if any bit of sincerity and honesty, the same exact logic that you say, well, okay, you're right, pun that my mother 100% exists. You never met her. You never see her.
And the universe exists.
So I said to you, the universe, it exists. Like how we say, you exist.
Right.
Because you said the universe exists.
Right.
Practice of the universe. No universe.
Prior to the existence of the universe.
There ain't no universe.
Hang on. The universe
was not
in my view now. We're going into my belief now. We're going into your belief. So we're talking about beliefs now. Not knowing. So in my belief now, the universe has always existed in one way, shape, or form.
Always been existed.
Always existed in one way, shape, or form.
Why you said the universe always existed between one way, shape, or form? One way.
Because we know nothing pops into existence, yeah?
Yeah.
We know that.
Yeah.
Nothing just pops into existence. So if the universe is in this form,
we mean that nothing created something. Nothing gives existence to something.
Right. So there was always something, yes? There's always been something. Do you agree?
Something that gives existence to the universe, you're right.
There's always been something then.
That gives existence to the universe.
Okay, so the question now becomes, what is that something?
That's something that's something and that's some and somewhat, whatever you want to call it. That's why we say that is the creator.
No. In your view.
No.
Hang on.
I can give a specific.
If I say it's a creator also, what's going to happen is we are going to agree that there's a creator.
Yeah.
We're gonna agree.
Yeah.
And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna get egotistical and arrogant on me.
No, I'm gonna get arrogant.
What?
Why would I get arrogant?
Because you're gonna say, yeah, there's a creator, but it's the one that I subscribe to. That's what you're gonna say. You're gonna say there's a creator, but it's the one that I subscribe to via this book, via this channel, via these people, via these prophets, everything.
Before,
that's what you're gonna do.
Before subscribe.
And now it comes back to not the creator, it comes back to you.
No. Before
you don't come back to the creator anymore.
Miss something.
And then hang on. And then the Jew's gonna say, yeah, there is a creator, but it goes by this book, by these people, by these prophets, by this, and it goes back to the Jew.
You missed something, brother.
It never ever goes back to the creator, my
friend. Before the subscribe, there's evidence that point me to the one that I subscribe to. There's an evidence first.
Evidence?
I said to you before, I don't take pushing back.
Bring your evidence.
No, for example, no. Universe, like you say, universe could not come from nothing.
I agree. It's always
you agree with that?
Shape or form,
prior to the universe, you have bestseller, Professor Crowe, and many great physicists. There are bestseller universe. From nothing. That before the universe, there were non-universe. It's not a universe. There were nothing before the universe. And where you wanna agree that universe cannot come from nothing. Universe could not create it itself. It's like saying a mother give birth to herself. That is zero. That cannot happen. Universe cannot give existence to itself. Universe cannot. Nothing cannot give existence to the universe, which is something now. The only option you have left. I'm, and I don't say anonymous, like I say your mother is still anonymous to me.
Go on. What's the option you got?
Yeah, I'm a, let me have you take this journey.
I'm on the train.
I have a conviction believer that I'm sure with you know. But I'm gonna go back to square one, like I say, I don't know the creator. But the only option logically what we're thinking now, me and you thinking, the other two universe what didn't exist before. I think that didn't exist before can give existence to itself. But I said give existence, we give pre-existence to it, and that is nonsense. Nothing can give existence to the universe, which is something. So those two is not plausible, we turn it down.
So it's always been something.
The only one left is that gotta be something, somewhat, some whatever you wanna call it to the moment.
Yes.
That give existence to the universe is there nothing before the universe.
Okay, hang on. Yes. Hang
so
on.
You agree with that one?
I agree. But however,
that's good.
No, but like I said to you, listen, in my belief, the universe has always existed in one way, shape, or form.
But when I said to you that universe next, like many bestsellers for universe.
In what form?
Universe from nothing.
In what form? Alright, let me make it easier for you.
What does nothing mean?
Let me make it easier for you. Did you exist 60 years ago?
No.
No. Did your parents exist 60 years ago?
No. No, 60. No, no.
Did your parents exist 50 years ago?
Yes.
Okay. So then, did you exist 50 years ago? In one way, shape, or form, you did, didn't you?
You're right.
Right. Okay, so what form did you exist in? You existed in a form of sperm and egg. So you have always existed. So you were in this form, my friend.
Hang on.
Listen to what I'm saying. You were not in this form.
You got me. And I was.
You were in another form.
But
in another way.
You're right.
Not
you're
this
right.
way.
You're right.
So the universe
right.
has always existed.
No.
In one way, shape, or form. Not this form, though. In another form.
No.
In this form, I'm not. No.
No. No. That's what I meant to ask. I forgot to ask.
In this form, no. Like I said, you've always existed in one way, shape, or form.
When you say that to me.
In the form of egg and sperm, you were in existence in your parents.
But when you say that to me.
So you were already in existence.
I take my to you.
Just not in this form.
No, when you say that to me, I take my to after you. Listen, when you say that to me. But I should have asked.
No, but you didn't exist. Because the sperm and the egg came together to form you. So though that egg and that sperm is you in another form. Yes or no?
I would like to disagree with that line of argument.
It's you in another form.
I don't disagree with that line of argument. Because the current talk about man, I will put him into a safe logic talking with when he was that in his sperm up in it. But what are you right when you got me the point? I should have asked you in this form.
Yes.
I didn't exist in this form. I should have asked you that.
Yes. It didn't exist in this form.
I should
no.
ask you what you meant.
It's another form.
So the fact that you can prove the form to me, and if you can't prove the form that the universe will exist before, then it's a nothing to us.
Right. But we aren't.
You give me evidence what farm it was as well.
No, I don't.
Then it's nothing to us.
No, wait. Because
we understand.
Hang on. Because we know that nothing pops into existence from nothing, right?
We know that nothing can give existence to something.
Right, exactly. So there's always been something. Yes, we agreed on that. There's always been something. So this something was the universe in another form.
No.
Yes, it was.
It was as this something is the creator of the universe.
Alright, let me take your reasoning then. Let me say, for the sake of this argument, I'm going to say Allah is eternal and he's always existed. I'm going to go somewhere. Yeah? So Allah has existed eternally. When Allah was in existence, yeah, was the universe in existence?
Allah is the one who gave existence to the universe.
I'm asking you a question. Was the universe already in existence when Allah was in existence?
At what point are you talking?
The beginning goes
before he created it? Before he gave existence to it?
In what form?
Before he gave existence to it?
Hang on. In what form?
Before he gave existence to it, it didn't exist.
No, but he did. He existed in Allah in a different form.
Allah said, blessed is the creator, the one who created from nothing.
But you said there's no such thing as nothing. You just said there's no such thing as nothing. There's always something.
The universe, there's another argument. Allah created the universe from nothing. Universal, let me read it. Universe was created by Allah.
Yes.
By and from is two different words. Universe was created by Allah.
From what?
From nothing.
There's no such thing as nothing.
Huh?
There's no such thing as nothing.
There's no such thing as nothing.
You already agree there's no such thing as nothing.
There's no such thing as nothing.
You already agreed with me there's no such thing as nothing. So how can Allah create something from nothing?
I'm telling you the truth. My book is empty. Why is it my first
time? I don't know.
Nothing.
You can have a gun in there for all I know, bro.
So I tell you from before, my pocket is empty. I feel it first, it's empty. What is in my pocket? If I say nothing is in my pocket,
there's always something in your pocket.
Wrong with that statement, if I say nothing is in my pocket.
My friend, there's always something in your pocket.
We're not talking about
whether it be oxygen, whether it be atoms, there's always something in your pocket. Like I said to you, there's no such thing as nothing. There's no such thing as nothing.
I'm saying nothing to the state. All right, the state of the universe that you have today.
Uh-huh.
You're talking about space and time. You're talking space and time.
Go on.
The universe, the space and time, the universe exists in space and time.
Right.
If you go to a certain dimension, you might call it light years, or you want to calculate by.
Are you talking about time? So are you now talking about something outside of space and time?
Yeah, but we're talking about trace evidences.
No, you said the universe.
Trace evidence. I said that your mother exists, but I never.
Did Allah or was a universe in existence when Allah was in existence? You said Allah created the universe from nothing, but we already agreed that there's no such thing as nothing. It's just Allah, isn't it?
I said to you, Allah created the universe from nothing. Meaning?
Does that make sense?
Hang on.
So calm down. Does that make sense? If it's just Allah in existence, it's only Allah.
Yeah.
How can Allah bring something into existence from nothing? It's only Allah.
That's why I said to you. That's what I said to you, blessed is Allah.
All right.
I said to you, blessed is Allah. The best of creator, I tell you that is incomparable to that creator. Allah creator, I'm talking about material. Allah creator, I'm getting raw material.
That's your belief now?
Yeah, but I can give you evidence in the same book.
No, you can't give me evidence for anything that creates something
remember you said to
you
me.
You understand that?
Remember the first line when I said to you that the universe can the universe give existence itself? You said no to that as well.
I agreed then. But I told you it was already in existence in another form. But we already agreed nothing that we know of. You can't show me anything that can bring. Hang on. You cannot show me anything that can bring anything into existence from nothing. Show me something that can do that.
You don't realize that you can't take this volume. You say you believe that the universe cannot give existence to itself. But they said the universe always exists in another form.
In another form.
That means then the universe gives existence to itself then?
No, because it's always been in existence in another form. Just like you were always in existence in your parents.
Okay.
In another form.
Oh, okay. So
do you understand?
So actually, no. The sperms from my dad and the egg from my mother in another form. Merely to itself, is that the force that do what it does and bring me into this form?
Say that again.
The sperms to itself, merely on its own, from my dad.
Right.
And the egg from my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Merely by itself. Is that the force by itself, merely to itself, does what it does and bring me into this form? Is there another force behind it?
Who was the force? What was the force?
I'm asking you.
The force was your parents having sex.
Yes.
That was the force.
And then if we synchronize it now, what we're going to get to know? Then we're speaking about this now, we have to have some other now. My parents are involved in that intercourse and this thing before.
Right.
What makes it possible for them to involve it, to the other stage that they could involve
their
it?
Their parents.
And then go back.
Their parents.
And then we go back.
And then we go back.
And then we're going to go back. There's a time when the first one didn't exist, isn't it?
When was that?
I'm asking you, we're gonna go back to the time when the first one exists.
When was that? Because I don't know when that is.
But the man cannot be always existing.
Hang on, I'm just saying. But what do we know? That everything was already in existence in one way, shape, or form.
Why does the man cannot always be existing?
Like
why,
I said.
Why? Because you have an ending point. Have a beginning point.
Yes. But
that is clear content.
But everything is already in existence in one way, shape, or form. So everything has already always existed.
Yeah, what I'm saying from the initial stage, you're saying is the driving force that kick itself into those form, those practical precise form with like DNA structure, these things. Is there a force behind it?
The force behind it is the same force that it is.
That it is?
The force that's behind it.
I agree there's a force behind all of
this. Listen.
You agree?
No, this is what I said. The same force behind it is the same force that it is.
But you don't know what that force
is. Hang on. The same force that's in you is the same force that brought you into existence. What is that force? Energy is that force.
And there's that energy.
That is all we know of, my friend.
You want to say energy, you want to say power?
Energy. Okay, you want to take power? I say power is energy. It's all energy.
Yeah, but I'm saying that initial force that you say, that initial force, you gotta have an initial force that does have a beginning. That does born in by space and time. Because we know that space and time is also created. We know that now. Mm-hmm. Space and time is created. We know that.
When you say created, this is what I mean you can't understand. No? I don't believe in creation. I say transformation.
But you don't know that initial force.
Hold that down. Transformation from one form to another form. Just like you transform from the egg and the sperm into this form. And in you right now, and in your partner right now, are your children. They're not even in existence yet. They're not in existence yet, but they exist in you and her. And it takes two energy forms to come together to transform those two pieces of energy, which are sperm and egg, into the form of your child. So your child can have the same conversation 20 years from now, saying, oh, we're gonna have the same conversation.
Does energy move after all? I'm talking about initial energy that brings the front. You say, but that's initial.
The initial energy is the same energy. It's all one. It's not separate from one another. It's not separate.
That initial energy gotta be an energy that have no beginning, and it gotta be detached.
Right. So energy is eternal.
Like Stephen Hawking says.
I agree.
Stephen Hawking says one of the greatest physicists. He says, when we study this universe, there's got to be a point of reference outside of that universe that is completely different from it, that gives existence to it.
Let me ask you a question.
He said, when we study this universe, there's got to be a point of reference outside of it.
Let me ask you a question.
It cannot be like it, and it got to be one.
Yeah, but let me ask you a question.
Literally, Stephen Hawking is not perfect.
Yes.
He explained in the description of the Quran, or the chapter he's explaining, I don't even know his explanation.
Listen.
He don't even know his explanation. He didn't know.
But let me ask you a question. What do we know outside of our universe?
What do you know about your
universe? No, what do we know as human beings outside of our universe? What do we know?
I know many things outside of the universe.
Tell me one thing, because I don't know shit about outside the universe, because everything we know exists within the realms of our universe. You don't know anything outside the universe. Tell me one thing outside the universe, bro.
Because then I could say to you, then, oh, do I know what is outside of the universe?
No. We don't know as human beings. We have to be humble enough, you know,
yes,
to say we know nothing.
And if you were truly humble, you would have known. That's
Hang on. We know nothing
about
anything outside the universe, bro.
And the fact that you didn't know because you weren't humble enough. When you're humble enough, and you seek the knowledge, falling from the initial chest evidences, like one of the great places, one of them say, when you see design, it shall tell you there's a designer.
Right.
You know, the precise measurement, it's not the right position for life to exist. A bit closer, we all die, a bit far away. It's a coincidence. Look at the DNA and the information stored and the ways that it stores it. Precise calculation, precise measurement, precise position.
Have you ever seen the stars at night time?
You never see stars. You can't see stars. You see portion of stars. You never see
every
stars.
Every star in the sky is a sun. Do you know that?
You can't see stars?
Every star in the sky is a sun. Do you know that?
That's not
Hang on. Every star in the sky is a sun, my friend.
Yeah, I said to you, you say see stars.
So you think there's a possibility. I don't know.
No, I mean,
there's people right out there having the exact same conversation that we're having. Do you know how many planets there could be?
The argument is flawed. It's a sea star. We never see stars. You don't know that.
So you don't see stars?
We see portion of the star. We can never see stars.
So the sun is not a star?
We never see stars.
Hang on. So our sun is not a star?
We see portion of the star. We never see stars.
What do you mean?
Those stars at night time you're talking about, we don't see portion of the star.
Do you see the sun every day?
We see sun.
Is that a star?
Night. I don't see the sun in the night.
All right, fine.
So I take you mean a different star then. See, even then it doesn't really matter what you're saying. You say, yes, but night first. Do you see the sun at night?
My friend, do you see the sun every day?
Yes.
Depends on is the sun a star?
Depends on all the settings.
Is the sun a star?
What, who defines as a star? Do you define as a star?
Come on, man. The sun's a star. It's our closest star. The stars in the sky are not our closest stars, okay? But there are millions and billions of them there.
I'm being honest with you. I know that's a sun. Who defines as a star? No. I don't know. You tell me. Educate me.
Okay, astrophysicist.
What source you working after you define a star?
Astrophysicists that know more than me can look into the universe, and you know what they've said? They're not concluded. we know 4%, roughly about 4% of our universe. But we know. There's 96% of the universe that we have absolutely no clue about, yet and still you're here telling me, yeah, it was Adam.
But it no exists.
That's what you're doing.
But it no exists.
Huh?
But it no
exists. Of course it exists.
How did it not exist? How did it not exist?
Because you're here, it exists.
My first evidence is the same when I established that your mom exists and I never met her, I never see her in my life, she's anonymous to me.
Right.
And you agree with that line of argument. And it's the same line of argument that the creators produced in the Quran. When it says, were they created by nothing? Are they created at the universe and the earth? It's the same line of trace evidence argument you're giving you for anyone those who think and reflect. Alternation between night and day, like someone eating this fish consistently.
The Quran, for decades. The Quran came from where?
Is that coincidence?
Hang on, the Quran came from where?
The Quran is from the creator of the heavens and the earth.
Hang on, the Quran is from inside the universe.
Isn't it?
It's not from outside the universe. If you had something from outside the universe that I could refer to, that it came from outside the universe, then I could say, yeah, there you go, mate, you got it. You haven't got anything from outside the universe.
Use Usher Fizz, and I give you one of the famous of our time, which says, when we study the universe, there's got to be a point of reference outside of it, which is detachable from it.
Okay, so hang on.
Stephen Hawking
is detachable from this universe. Is that hypothetical? Is that hypothetical? Is it a belief? Or is it annoying?
You see, you'll be in confusion. You'd always be ruffled. I agree with you when you say you cannot person watches outside of space. Equator watches outside of space and time. I agree with you. I agree with any atheist that says I don't watch that because I can't see. I agree with them. How do I know about my creator? I have strict rules as a Muslim. I don't know about the Christian I can follow. I speak about the creator, what he revealed to himself.
Do you know that the Jews do the same thing?
Huh?
You know the Jews do the same thing, right?
But the Jews have a trustword and a preserved scripture today that they can say, well, this is preserved. So I can trust it.
So then we start arguing now.
Yeah.
Oh, they, he's wrong, he's wrong. No, he's wrong, and he's wrong, and he's wrong, and he's wrong. This is what happens.
So I say, give me an ID, and the ID is tampered with a sign and evidence. It's fraud. I cannot trust 100%. But if you give me
hang on.
And your name is that.
Hang on. If I know that the Jew one is fraud, you stand on the shoulder of the Jews.
That's what I'm trying to say to you.
So why would you co-sign a fraudulent book? Why would you say, yeah, we want that part of the fraudulent book, but we don't want that part of the fraudulent book? So you now decide which parts of the fraudulent book you want to follow.
I'm about following truth. When you verify it, and you question things, and you go down and you're critical of stuff, I say, okay then, the creator has no motive for lying. The creation cannot harm him. Nah.
But human beings have motive for lying, though, don't they?
For you.
Now, hang on, you said the creator has no motive for lying, yeah?
But human beings have motive
for lying.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so who wrote the Quran? Human beings or the creator?
Quran was revealed in the art.
So who wrote the Quran, the Injil and the Torah? Human beings or the creator?
The Quran, the Quran, when the Quran put it in book format, he didn't put the Quran in book format to preserve it. The Quran needed to go into book format to preserve it.
Are you answering my question, you guys?
I'm answering your question now.
Okay.
It's the recited practice in the Quran. God says the Quran, God give you the remedy. God give you the answer to the Quran. Oh, Muhammad, I'm going to make you recite this Quran. Repetitive recitation.
You know what we're doing now? We're just going into beliefs and books and stuff. It's nothing of substance.
Yeah,
because the same thing that you can say to me right now about your book, the Jew can say to me about their book.
They can't.
And the Christian can say to me about their book. And then if I say to you, hang on, if I say to all three of you, do you guys all know what this creator is? And you all going to say, yeah. And if I put you all three of you in a room and say, all right, you guys talk about the creator going, you're all going to disagree and start fighting one another. So then how would I now know who is the right one?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Would I know that?
All right, if you said to me, if someone said to you, okay, I came with the Quran and said, well, this Quran is from the creator. Look into it from front to back. You could have given a falsification test. If this Quran is from no one, apart from the creator, this Quran came from no one apart from the creator, could have some quality, it doesn't contradict.
Let me tell you something.
It says, then pick out one, then produce something like it. Pick out one contradiction. You give me the Jewish scripture now, I pick contradiction. It's a clear sign. The Bible, our magazine, 1956, the Bible of over 50,000. Remember, the Bible engulfed, the Torah claim, Torah and Gospel. Over 50,000 contradiction. But on the other side, I was coming from that source. I was reading those books. I see them myself.
Contradiction in the Quran.
Eh?
Let me show you contradiction in the Quran. What else that contradicts the Quran, let's say. Who was the first man?
First man, Adam.
Okay.
Yeah.
According to what book?
Eh?
According to what book? To the Quran.
Yeah.
Okay, so according to history.
And according to Torah.
So according to history, science, anthropology, archaeology, who were the first human beings? If you don't know, I'll tell you.
Some guys from Africa, some black guy, they say.
So you're not telling me Adam was an African?
The angels of God.
I'm not going to say that to you. I'm not going to say that.
Of course you wouldn't, because it would contradict your Quran.
I'm not going to say that. What I'm saying to you, through the course of time, people change names. You might say to me, I say, well, these guys are Jamaica. Not Jamaican. I said, yes. I said, I'm from Jamaica. I said, he's a Jamaican then. I was born there. I said, no, I'm not a Jamaican. What do I mean? People change name. Why? Because it was Zay Maka before.
Change whose name?
The title Jamaica, the island.
No, but what I'm trying to say to you is, if the first human beings were African, they would have African names, not Arabic ones, or Hebrew ones, or Chinese ones, or Japanese ones, wouldn't they? They would have African names, wouldn't they? The first man would have an African name because he's African, yes or no?
Hmm.
Okay, so is Adam an African name?
Is the source of the African name, origin of African's name, African names, originated. Origin African names, originated.
Africans did.
African when?
Whenever they existed.
And what was it like? Oh, you know Adam was the one.
You see what I'm saying?
Oh, you know Adam was the one.
I tell you what I do know.
Oh, you know Adam was the
Listen,
one.
Listen, I tell you what I do know. The name Adam is from the Hebrew language. That's what
Adam. Adam with a strong Adam.
Listen, it doesn't matter. The name Adam is not from the Japanese language, is it?
So is it possible?
Hang on. Is the name Adam from Japan?
No.
No, it's not, is it? Is the name Adam from Hebrew?
Is it possible?
I'm asking you. Is the name Adam from Hebrew?
Yeah.
Okay. So where the Hebrews are first people.
So I'm asking you now.
Hang on. Were the Hebrews the first people? No. Africans were. So how now can an African be running around with a Hebrew name when an African existed 100,000 years before the Hebrew language even existed?
Well, okay, so African is the first person and the name African. When the name African come into being Africa and these things?
No, you see what I'm saying?
It's not even called
Africa. Now you're running. I'm saying to you.
It's even called Africa. This is not coined by the outsider.
Whether you call it Africa or not.
That's my point,
the
brother.
The first man was a black African from the continent that we now know as Africa. That's where the first man and woman were from.
Yeah.
But we also know that that first man and woman was 100, 200, 300,000, however many. But we do know that the language you're speaking about, to call him, his name, is about 6 to 8,000 years old. So, but the first man is not 6 to 8,000 years old. He's 100,000 years old. So, how is 100,000 year old man got 8,000 year old name?
And the evidence is that the scientists do what?
No, I'm asking.
What's the evidence for that?
Etymology of language. The Hebrew language came from Nabataean, the Nabataean language, which was before the Babylonian language, which was before. Languages evolve, yes. They don't just appear out of nowhere. So, the name Adam came from a certain language base, which the Hebrew language base. Whenever it came from the Japanese language base, I don't know where you're from, sorry to point to you, my friend. But Adam is not an original name in this guy's language.
What does Adam mean?
I don't care what it means.
You see what you say?
No, I don't care what it means. I'm talking about the language. The language that the name Adam came from, is impossible for a man that is an African living 100,000 years ago to have a name called Adam. Just impossible, because the name Adam wasn't even in existence in linguistics.
So it's impossible for me to name Rory. Name of my birth preference is Rory. It's impossible.
Say again?
Look at me, I'm a black man, my forefather is from Africa. It's impossible for me to have a Rory as Scottish name.
So explain to me how you got a name called Rory.
No,
explain to me, there's an explanation.
No, you have the explanation because you're very clever.
Okay,
now.
I'll explain to you.
I'm giving it.
Your parents or your forefathers were enslaved by white Europeans.
Yes.
When they were enslaved by white Europeans, the white Europeans gave the Africans their name.
Yes.
That's why you got a name called Rory. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
And that was changed.
Did the Hebrews enslave Africans and give them Hebrew names?
My point is, and that was changed. That was changed based on language itself. Language merely by itself is not bad. God give us the ability. People invent language, and it's merely by itself is not bad. But see, when you use that way, like the slave, and use for a negative way like that, then it's bad.
You're going somewhere else, mate.
No, listen, I'm trying to say to you.
You're going somewhere else, my brother. You're going somewhere else.
My point is,
I'm telling you, it is absolutely impossible using etymology of language for the first man to be called Adam. It's impossible.
So God says the Quran, what do we send scripture to a prophet? We send it in the language that they spoke. Does that negate that there's no language before? But so when we send scripture to a prophet, and that was in a revelation now, scripture to a prophet, we send it in the language that they spoke.
Right?
It makes sense.
Hang on, you're not even making any sense. Because I will say to you, if Allah existed, did Allah give the first man the name Adam? Did he give it to him? Did he say, this man, his name is Adam? And did Adam know his name was Adam? Yes or no?
He must know his name, yes.
Okay, so then what you're saying is, from the beginning of humanity, the man's name was Adam. Not that, oh, he got it because we gave it to him in a scripture 100,000 years later and we used that language. No, you are saying in the beginning when God created the first man, he said, this man is called Adam.
What's his name?
But hang on a minute, the name Adam wasn't even in linguistics, my friend.
What's evidence?
It didn't even exist.
What's the name? What's the evidence that the name Adam never exists?
Because we go back to etymology of language. The etymology of the Hebrew language, where the name Adam comes from, it doesn't come from a Japanese base, a Samoan base, an Indian base, an African base. It comes from a Hebrew based language.
And what is
and the Hebrew based language is only about 8,000 years old.
This is probably good. This epidemiology, what you call it. What is the
let's keep going.
What is the evidence that is 100% correct to assess the name Adam? What's the evidence that touchstone we call
etymology? Etymology of language.
Yes. What is the evidence that is 100% correct to assess the name Adam?
You see what I'm saying?
What is the evidence?
Because etymology of language.
Why is it?
Okay, I'll show you.
How does it work? What are they doing it?
You're speaking English, yeah?
Yeah.
How did English come to
me? Wait.
English came from what? Latin, German.
It's a bastard language.
It's a bastard language. It comes from all kinds of languages, and it came together to make English. English did not just spring up out of nowhere. It didn't spring up out of nowhere, did it? No. It came together to make the language English. The language of Hebrew, again, came together to make the language. That's why if your name is Rory, you won't find a Rory in Japan as an original language base, original name. You might find Yoshimoto or Yamaha or
Suzuki.
But you won't find Rory there. You won't find a Rory.
Maybe a different name before that. Japan might call different people before that name. You see, might change all the time.
So now you're in the world of might be.
And now you're on as well. You know, I have a solid evidence.
Now you're on rocky ground.
You know,
but you're telling me it's 100% correct, the Quran, isn't it?
Yes.
So there is no room for, maybe. Is there? There's no room for maybe.
You didn't ask me to prove that it is correct. You see, you never asked it. That would be a clever question from you.
I prove that it's incorrect. I don't need your proof. I'm an African.
What's the proof is incorrect?
I know that Adam's not an African name. I'm smart enough to know that. Just like he's smart enough to know that Adam's not from his people's name.
So Adam,
he knows his people's
so
name.
Adam have to be African to be the first man. You see, scientists do this, but all you know is the test that they done and what they are with the fossil and whatever they observe. All you know the conclusion of the person address. Correct. All do you know? All do you know the conclusion of what they assess and the
etymology. Just study etymology of language.
I'm asking you, breaking it for me.
Just study.
I don't know, educate me now.
Study it.
All does it work? And all does it prove?
I showed you.
It's a qualified tool.
I showed you
to prove that this
the
man
English
name is this.
Language is a bastard language coming from
no,
a lot
English
of other
alone.
Languages.
Leave English.
No, all languages do
no,
this.
No, leave English. I'm asking about something specific.
Listen.
About Adam, the name Adam, and those people that done that the experiment.
Okay, I'll ask you a question again.
Give me the breaking.
I'll ask
they
you
done,
a question. Can you find the name Adam?
You don't even know what they done.
Listen.
You're just guessing. You
can
hear
you find the name Adam outside of the Semitic language base? The name Adam. But I'm asking you a very specific question. Can you find the name Adam outside of the Semitic language base historically?
I said one.
I'm saying to you.
Is that Adam?
Yeah.
It's a different language.
No, it's not.
We say Adam. English.
I can say Edward and Eddie.
You mean the same thing, right?
I can say Edward and Eddie. Yeah. We found Edward. No, that's Eddie.
I'm asking.
No, it's Edward. No, it's actually Eddie.
I'm asking,
so I'm asking you. Can you find the name Adam? Outside the Hebrew language or the Semitic language base in any other continent historically?
Yes.
You have to show me that, mate. Can you find it in Japan? Can you find it in Samoa? Can you find it in China? Can you find it in India?
Adam is the name of the first human being, obviously.
Oh, you see what I'm saying? We're back to the nonsense now.
Yeah, but what you
we're back to the nonsense.
What you said with no evidence was nonsense. What you said with no evidence was nonsense. You see, that's
the
point.
I'm asking you to use your brain, brother.
But I'm asking you the same thing.
Asking you to use your brain.
Give me proof of what you said. So I'm asking you, give me proof of what you said.
I'm asking you, you are the proof. You're smart enough. You're not a stupid man, you know.
I said, Quran is my proof that the first man
named. You're not a stupid man because you said your name's Rory, yeah?
Yes.
And you said, and I said to you, how did you get the name Rory? And we explained, we knew. Because your forefathers were enslaved by Europeans, and they gave the slaves their names. The slaves, originally, you can't go to Africa and say, hey, Rory. Who are you talking about? Who is Rory now?
I said to you, brother.
Rory is not an African name, is it? Now ask me a question. Is Rory an African name?
Nawa.
No, you know it's not an African name. You know it's an English name or a Scottish name, whatever.
Brother, Africa.
Just like
if
Adam
so, if so deep,
is not an
if,
African
if
name.
So, if you wanna go so deep, Africa is not an African name.
I agree. So the continent I said to you before in the conversation. No, it doesn't. Stop trying. Stop the semantics.
It doesn't have any crumbles.
Listen.
It means nothing.
The continent we now know as Africa.
You don't know what was before Africa then.
That's what I'm saying to you.
You don't know what was before Africa.
The continent
Adam was before Africa.
So I'm saying, you're talking nonsense.
Oh, nonsense.
The name Adam is only 8,000 years old. How can Adam be before Africa?
Yes.
And Africa's
because
been in existence from
Africa.
Because I'm more empirical trace evidences. I'm more practical than you in my exam. I'm taking that name from a trustworthy source.
It's trustworthy now.
Wait. Let me tell you why it's trustworthy. That explained the beginning of creation. That explained the water cycle when no source never did before it. That's a trustworthy source for me to take the name of Adam that is the first man from. But when you say, okay, a science, Western scientists, and you know they lie about you when they speak about the black man as well. Let's add that in there. They do epistemology and the fossil and these things. What make you think that the experiment and the conclusion was correct? What touched on the working up? How did it work? Explain it, break it up to me.
You know what it sounds like to me?
How did you know the correct when they give you the conclusion? How did you know?
You know what it sounds like to me?
No, answer the question. Answer the question.
I can't answer it. I tell you why I can't answer it.
That's it.
Because no matter what answer I give you, you're going to run from it. I cannot answer the question for you because I've given you about three answers already and you run from all of them. So why are you asking me to give you one again? You're running from your comments.
You say etymology and the study of names and Africa. And I say, you even say Africa, but I say, Africa is the African name. And you don't understand what deep that is. That's a deep burn, man.
I don't mind it not being an African name. So I don't care. I'm talking about the continent we now know as Africa. Whatever name you give it, the first people were from there. Whatever name you give that, you could give the continent the name Jacket for all I care. But the first people were from this continent, yes or no?
So African language.
And they spoke a language.
How do you know African language was the first language? How do you know African language is not the first language? How do you know?
I don't know, it's not.
How do you know it's not the first language?
Of course it is. They're African.
If Africa have a place itself, Africa is the African language.
Okay, listen.
Africa is
that. Yeah, but you understand what I'm saying? Stop trying to be silly. The language, the continent we know as Africa, year-old language to superimpose on a people that are not 8,000 years old.
My point is, how do you know?
Because we know language. I want to educate me. Just like you know, your name ain't Rory because the English people were called Rory. And you're a black man. Scottish.
Yes.
You know that. You're smart enough to know.
My forefather name can change as well.
Listen to what
impossible.
Why are you running from this? You know that the Scottish are called Rory. You know that the people on the black continent that they call Africa were not called Rory. Yes? You know that. Don't you?
I am aware to most extent.
You know that.
Yeah.
So like I'm saying to you, you also know that the name, that the Hebrew was only 8,000 years old and the people on that continent are older than that.
But
you also know that, but you're running from it.
My forefather in West Africa, what they were called, I don't know if it was the original for that place. It's my point.
You're running from it, bro.
You have to have some evidence. If you say it's the origin name that my forefather
You are the original man. You black man with that black skin are the original man. However, you are taking a book and a people and a God from a people that ain't even you.
But I'm trying to say it to
so
you.
So of course I understand why you're confused.
Because
you're confused from the get-go.
One who give evidence can't be confused.
You're confused from the get-go, bro.
The confused man is the one who don't give no evidence.
Listen to what I'm saying.
You are
confused from the get-go. You are a black original man talking Arabic, talking about Arabic names, Hebrew this. You're a black man. Be a black man.
Black.
Why are you looking to other people to give you your history
when you
are the oldest man on the earth? Why are you doing that?
Why define me as a black
man? Why are you doing that?
Why you define me as a black man? Why?
Why are you doing that? You tell these people how things came to be. You don't let them tell you. You are the original. You are the parent. Yet and still, you're taking your child's. No, you're taking the child's book. You're taking the child's language. You're taking the child's culture and telling people that this is the first.
You said to me.
You are crazy, my friend.
It's setting me, we don't know because we don't humble. If I be walking around telling people, then that's not humbleness, that's arrogance.
My friend, it's not arrogant for your parents to know they're your parents. It's not arrogant. It's not human.
It's arrogant to deny your creator when the sign is everywhere.
No, my friend, I told you already.
That's arrogant.
Listen, I don't deny no creator.
You see design.
Like I said to you.
You see design, but you say, you're so clever. You see design. But
bro,
there's no design
then
for design.
Then you use your knowledge as a black African man.
This jacket have design on it. There's a designer.
Then you use your knowledge as a black African man. Yes.
Name for Adam.
You use your knowledge as a black African man. Yeah. To know that these people that gave you this Quran are your children.
In Africa, they use the
they're your children. Yes, they are. They're our children. This man, that man, that man, and this man here are the fathers.
Even the
these
Chinese.
People are your children,
you
and you're telling, and you're taking these people.
You listen to Louis Farrakhan, I think you listen too much.
No, not Louis Farrakhan.
What do you mean they're our children? What do you mean? Explain
meaning,
to me.
Meaning, we are the original people. We gave birth to them.
What do you mean? Break it down for me.
Genetics. Every person, every human being.
And then who give birth to us?
Hang on.
Who give birth to us?
You want to start from the... You want
to
start?
Who give birth to us?
Your parents did.
He said, we're the original person. I mean, all this thing. He said, the original, the first man is black.
Yeah.
Who give existence to that first man?
Like I said, and we agreed before in the conversation.
Who give existence?
The energy did. The source did.
Who is the energy?
We don't know what the source is. The source is the source, bro.
You know what source? What is it possible? Alright, anonymously, that source. If that source give existence to something, which become a practical human being that can walk, it can rationalize,
yeah.
It can think, it can have conversation, then the source must be a form of an intelligence source to give existence to intelligence.
Right.
You cannot have.
But what do you call that source?
If I'm not intelligent, can I teach my children to be intelligent?
I'm not saying you can't.
Eh?
Listen to where you're going.
You don't have order from another.
Listen to where you're going, though.
You don't have order from another, brother.
Yeah, but listen to where you're going. You are the original source, yet and still, you are using a children's source.
I'm agree. Come close approach. I'm agree.
A children's source.
Right, so I agree with that.
To talk to you about your originality.
Okay.
Go back to your home.
Okay. The creator of the universe.
And go back to the source.
Okay. Creator of the universe with children. Okay. Okay. The creator of the universe.
No, I'm talking about
with children.
No, because you got that belief that this book is from
that
source.
At least I'm giving proof of my belief, but you're not giving up proof of what you're saying.
You ain't got no proof, bro.
You tell me scientists. What scientists say? Estimology and these things. Tell me a word, break it down for me.
You can't even prove.
Why they come to that conclusion?
You can't even prove the source that you're talking about. But there's no proof.
There's no source. I'll give you an example. Quran is the first source. There's no source, no other book you have in history. You bring them and give them to me. No source that predate the Quran that explain the correct function of the water cycle.
What water cycle? What's the water cycle?
No source before the Quran give you the correct function of the water cycle. Or does it work?
What is the water cycle?
Eh?
So many books.
What is the water cycle? What is
the document in the world in history?
I said, bring me then.
Huh? Well, I don't know.
I said, bring me.
He's not a scientist.
I said, the first source is the Quran. I said, the first source is the Quran. For you to override that, you bring me something else.
Let me.
I can bring you the Quran and tell what it says about the water cycle. When the Greek and the Roman, then before that, and Democritus, and they're all getting it wrong.
Let me tell you something.
For you to say the burden is on you, I don't need hypothetical from you. Give me a source. Give me a source. Give me a source of certainty.
No, that's the biggest.
No, I'm asking you. Give me a source. Give me a source of certainty. Give me a source. Give me a source.
That's the biggest hypothetical going.
No.
Give me a source of certainty.
That's the biggest hypothetical going. That explain the water cycle. You don't have it. But I can give you the Quran as a certain source.
Okay.
I'm unpredictable.
Give me a source.
That's the evidence that's from the Quran.
Wait. Give me a source that shows me, that shows everyone how to build the pyramids.
Yeah, where's the...
Give me a source.
Thank you.
That shows me how to build the pyramids of Giza, aligned with Orion's belt, 20 ton, 40 ton, 50 ton blocks on top of one another, within a centimeter of one another, slotting no cement with the tools that they had 6,000 years ago. Bring me the source to show me how they did that.
I can give you the source.
Really?
God.
No, you see what I'm saying? Bro, you don't understand how crazy you sound, you know? Let me tell you something. You can't even prove God. What are you going to give me God as a source? What are you talking about?
The pyramid.
one. You can't insert one. Listen, bro, bro, bro.
He compliment this building. Bro,
you cannot insert God into an equation that you can't
understand.
Do you know
the pyramid? No, wait, wait. Even know Billet? Do you know Billet?
If
I know Billet, but you don't even know Billet. You're talking. Do you know Billet?
You know God built
the pyramid. Do you know Billet?
The Africans that built it.
Oh, give me his name.
I don't know them.
Give me the little construction name.
Minanua.
That's the problem with you. So you should learn something. You see, you don't have his knowledge. That's the problem with you.
My friend,
I have his name, but you don't even know his name.
You have the guy's name.
Yes.
Okay. All right. I will tell you the architect. Imhotep was an architect.
Oh,
Imhotep was an architect.
Don't talk about
it. It was an architect.
Otep, no.
Imhotep was an architect.
No.
Let's hear this answer. Let's hear this.
No.
So, all right, so who's got the pyramid? Who's the guy's name? Give me the guy's name.
No,
give me the guy's name. I know Imhotep was an architect.
He said he don't know, and then he give me a name after.
No, the architect. No, the architect. You asked me the person who built it. I'm giving you the architect. Who is the one that built the pyramid then?
Come on, you know the name.
I gave you the architect. Who's the one that built it?
Brother, who is what? Louisa, when I say to you, when I say to you, I give the credit to God, when I say to you, because the question is, who created the man? Who gave him the arm that he used, the intellect? Who gave him these things? But if you deny the creator, then I understand. But I say, if you deny the creator, I say you're worse than 5-year-old children, because I got children now, 5-year-old, I don't even tell them. They got to be a God exists. When you look around the creation. Hey, okay, you see, but the creation, the way it is, and you say there's no creator. You see the design? They got to be a designer.
Did he say build the pyramids?
He ain't said yet.
Oh.
He ain't told me who built the pyramids yet.
The chief builder for the Egyptian, the chief builder was Amman. The chief builder for them was Amman.
Amman? Who's that?
Amman, yes. Amman. Yeah, thank you for
pronouncing. Who's that?
That was the chief builder for them.
Who's that? Where you get that information?
As a chief builder. And that,
who
and
is that and where'd you get that information?
And that name go way back.
And then who is that back. And where'd you get the information
and then
from?
Go way back.
Yeah. Alright, you're not going to answer that question.
Yeah.
Who is Amman and where'd you get the information from?
You have city like Asian city like in Elba, long before Egyptian city. Asian city. In the ruin they find it.
I said,
and his name are there.
Who is
there.
Amman and where'd you get the information from?
Amman was the chief builder amongst the pharaoh. But the pharaoh needs something to be
What pharaoh? What pharaoh was this?
Amun. Eh?
What pharaoh was this?
Yes.
What pharaoh was this?
Amun.
Egyptian.
Amun.
There's many pharaohs. What pharaoh are you talking about?
Yes, a dynasty. Yes, many. But I'm not saying amongst them.
Amman. What dynasty?
The name Amman.
What dynasty were the Egyptians, were the pyramids built?
But the name Amman is also a dynasty, if you know, alongside with the pharaoh dynasty.
Okay, listen.
The builder is like, the name even also of his
what
meaning.
What dynasty?
It means a betrayer. It means a meaning.
What dynasty?
The name of its meaning.
When did you get
this? As I said to you.
What information? Wait,
what about name? About what meaning? You see, when God give a name, meaning have an impact. We talk about meaning.
Bro, you're talking for Susie Fasazi right now.
I'm saying to you, but
you're talking some for Susie
Fasazi.
You
said the first one was the African name. Africa's the African name. You don't have nothing to say to that. Your argument failed. Your argument destroyed totally. Africa is the African name. The way it's inside of Africa, what does it stand?
He's asking, where do you get this?
If Africa is
I've asked him about 5 times, he's not answering me.
You can't assume that Africa is an African name. You defeat your own self by saying that.
No, listen to what I said.
Africa is an African name.
And listen to what I said. Listen to what I said to you. It doesn't matter what
this
you
is silly,
call
son.
Listen. It doesn't matter what you call the continent.
Yes.
It doesn't matter. I said the continent we now know as Africa. Yes?
Yeah.
It could have had a different name before.
Yeah. You can't make out something different.
The people from this
stop with semantics.
That's how you've been with. That's how you've been
you
with Adam.
You Muslims and your semantics.
That's how you've been when I say Adam.
When you can't win
Adam
an argument,
have a meaning. Adam mean man.
Semantics.
Adam mean man. It have a meaning.
In whose
that's
language?
How you've been.
In whose language?
So I said to you.
In whose language?
In whose language?
Yeah.
It have a meaning.
Yeah.
If you want to be
in whose language,
brother. If you want to be discriminated and not appreciate other language, you can get your role.
Bro, you're an African. Go back to the African languages.
Names.
You are no. Stop going back to semantics.
What was it for?
To go back to the African language.
What was it for? What you call African language? What was it for? What you call it? Did you know? What was it for?
What is that got to do with the argument?
You got to do.
At that time.
What was it for? You call. What was it for? What you call African language?
What is that got?
Some said to me, Kemet. They said that's something before. What was it for? So what was it for? You call African languages? You never know. Maybe a different language that calls something different. That's the point I'm asking you, brother. It's a logical. It's a logical question.
The language of the people on that continent. Yeah. The language of the people on that continent.
Yeah.
Whatever it was called.
You don't know.
Hang on.
The Bible,
we don't know the name of every language, but what we do know, I'm trying to tell you what we do know. We do know Hebrews about 8,000 years ago. That's what we do know. So it's impossible for the oldest people to have an 8,000 year old language. It's impossible.
Is it
possible? Doesn't make no sense.
Is it possible for a name?
Chronologically, don't make no sense.
Is it possible for a name?
Etymologically, don't make no sense.
So you said Adam. You said Adam is a Hebrew language.
I've said that to you about 50 times.
What's the evidence that Adam is a Hebrew language?
Have you asked? How many times have I asked this question?
What's the evidence that Adam is a Hebrew?
Should I go to the etymology? Like, I'm going to go to the etymology.
But I want to learn. You can't teach me. What's wrong?
No, I'm going to go to the etymology.
Teach me if you're arrogant.
I want to learn something.
Online etymology dictionary, just so you understand. No. I'm going to help you. Online etymology. Look, Adam.
Who's behind this?
No, Adam.
People make website. People information.
Proper name, biblical name of the first man, progenitor of the human race, from Hebrew. Adam, man. Literally, read it. There you go. Read it.
Adam meaning man, innit?
Read it.
Yeah? So I'm asking you.
Just read it first. Stop talking and read it.
They find one in you, right?
It means it's older man.
I understand what you're saying.
Yes, in the Hebrew language.
But I'm trying to say to you, when you're giving this up, I'm trying to say to you, who put this information up? I can ask you those questions.
You said that you know
it. Oh, you know this information is right. Put this up. I can ask you those questions. That's a logical one. Oh, you know these people trustworthy. I can also ask you that.
Yeah,
exactly what you want to be saying when you're selective on asking about Islam. You can do all day long.
Like I said to you already, your logic has already dictated language. You know, we've had that conversation.
You think anyone can come forward?
3-4 times now. And we've agreed that you, Rory, are only Rory because of what? Because of the history of the language of the people that came to your forefathers' continent.
And at upper level, that's what I understand.
Right, okay. So we know, like I said to you before, the name Rory did not come from that continent. It came from the people that came to the continent.
But the Kunta Kente, I know all these names that you say. You say Kunta Kente is an African. So you say African name, Kunta Kente, innit? Is Kunta Kente the first man on the earth?
I never said he was.
On the continent?
No.
So how do you know, like, how many years back those old names struck down firmer?
Like I said,
was that different structure firmer?
Saying,
because they all
you're
do you
saying,
not know
how
that?
Do you not know? What you are now doing, yeah?
I'm asking you that.
Now listen, I'll tell you what you're doing. You are.
It's a logical question, brother. It's fine. Logical, very logical.
It's fine. You are in agreement that the Quran is a fact 100%, yes?
Yeah, but you get why I'm actually, I'm talking with you.
Because of the content of evidence that proves itself to be.
I ask you a question. Are you in agreement that the Quran is 100% fact?
Because evidence that led me to do so. Empirical
yes
evidence.
Yes or no?
Empirical evidence. I don't just believe something. See, you read something online and you believe it. But you don't do the background research.
Okay, so nothing.
What's the difference between me and you?
So this is what's going on here.
What's the difference between me and you?
I'll tell you what's going on here then. If you are in agreement that the Quran is 100% fact,
yeah,
nothing, absolutely nothing that I bring to you right now is going to make you understand anything, because if I bring to you etymology and I bring to you other things, you are not even going to accept it, because what it does, it goes against your Quran. So you are not going to accept it. So stop asking me for something that you know you're not going to accept.
Sorry.
You're not going to accept it. No, I've listened to this guy. I've listened and I'm in what language?
But does it mean that he started 8,000
years? What does it mean?
Is there room for probably in your Quran?
Let's look at the meaning
of the word. Is there room for probably?
What does it mean in Hebrew?
If you're saying, how can you know?
No, I'm asking you a question. Is there room for probably in your Quran? Or is it fact? There's no probably. Okay, stop talking about probably. Stop talking about probably.
Okay, we went back to Hebrew.
Estimologist assessment. You didn't give me no proof that it is correct and it can't be correct. You didn't give
what
me no proof.
What does it mean in Hebrew?
That's what I said to you.
What does it mean in Hebrew?
That's all you didn't give me. Hey, you know,
it's
you know exactly. You don't have no proof. You know you don't have no proof.
It's
pointless.
You read it on your phone, huh?
But I'm saying to you, I'm talking about a source.
Yes? So if we take the meaning of the word, could we speak it in the original African language saying amen? Is there a word in the original African language?
We don't know what the first language was. Okay. We don't know what it is.
Okay, but if we look at
linguistics
the meaning of the word,
linguistics have said that the oldest languages the are the ones that use clicks.
If we use
those kind of
languages. Yeah, so how did they say?
So you tell me man in a...
If they were...
You tell me man in that language, go on.
Okay, if he said a man will pass...
And then translate it to Adam.
How do you say a man will pass a clicks? How do you say a man will pass...
You don't
know nothing, bro. That's what I'm saying. They don't know nothing.
I'm asking you. I don't know, Aaron. I don't know. But you know. I agree to you. I can't get support. I don't know. But you don't. But you know. But one thing I do know, because I'm from a place I was raised like this, I don't take pussy in bag. So I say to you, give me evidence that the first language was click, click, click. Give me evidence.
Like I said to you, when you go back to ancient linguistics, right? When you go back to... Listen.
I'm listening to evidence very carefully.
Listen.
The first language was click, click, click.
All right, just listen. The first...
You can learn.
Hang on. Give me evidence. I will. You got to give me evidence that the first language was click, click, click.
Hang on.
I'm on that plan. I'm on that movie.
Hang on. Good. That's good that you're not on that. That you're on that point. Every person in this park today has African in their DNA. Evidence. African in the DNA.
Evidence.
DNA. Am I gonna bring you DNA right now? Evidence.
Proof.
Okay, let's.
You said it's not proof.
All right, hang on. Let's just go.
How would you say click language?
Sometimes people don't read because
you reckon they would have.
It can be all day long like this.
We the man came to see me yesterday.
You give me a website. Can I also what's the
they might have went.
Someone make that webpage. Someone put information. Who are those guys?
Keep going.
Okay, so if you go to the Human Genome, my friend, if you go to the Human Genome Project, right?
So who are behind that project?
His name is Spencer Wells.
Who is that guy? Where is he from?
A geneticist.
Where is he from?
Who is he from?
Yeah, what does he look and where is he from?
He's a geneticist, a European geneticist.
European.
Okay.
This is not an argument, brother.
What argument?
It's one big circle. Is he a European today? Is he a white man or a black man?
He's a white man.
Okay. And say he's our children.
Listen,
the black man's father. You are the father of the white man. You know, the African line. I don't say that, you know, but he's saying he's supported very strongly a while ago. So he tell me to go to my children for that knowledge.
That's right.
For the knowledge of what?
You see, you contradict yourself again. You say you're the black man. You should be telling these people, these white people.
Listen.
Telling them.
That's right.
Mr. Spencer is a white man from Europe, yeah.
Listen.
Oh my God. You chop yourself again, brother.
No.
You see, it doesn't make no sense again. It's a big circle and nonsense you're giving me.
I tell you why I'm making sense.
Yeah. He said, that's my children.
Hang on, wait.
He said, I should be telling them.
Wait. The history of Africa. Africa has been underdeveloped just a little bit. For the past 500, 600 years.
It's
been underdeveloped. It's been underdeveloped. By Europeans, by Arabs.
By the people.
Right, okay. So how do you now expect a people who have been underdeveloped for hundreds and hundreds of years to give you, today give you genetics?
Watch myself.
How do you expect to do that?
Don't edit me out.
I'm asking you the way that...
No, you can't. Okay, so, but what we do know, even without them giving us anything, is that we are first.
Yeah.
We knew that before them. Because the oldest monuments you can find in the world are from Africa.
Part,
so we've always existed before everyone else. We have been the originator. It doesn't
matter. Part, it's not about trust.
Wait. So we always knew we were first. They are catching up to know we were first with their genetics and their archaeology and all this. They're catching up. So we already knew it.
They have broken it for me. I don't know, but you have knowledge. You're the scholar. Broken all at work and proved to me that this is the reason why it is 100% correct.
Right,
you understand the line of argument?
Let's stop.
That's the one I'm asking
let's
you.
Just stop. Let's stop.
I want to learn.
Because nothing that I bring you is going, if it doesn't fit within your Quranic book, you're not going to accept it. So it's pointless. You're going to find...
If you give me evidence...
No, I'm giving you evidence. I'm giving you evidence. I will give you the Human Genome Project. You're telling me, oh, but how do we know?
You said Spencer.
I will give you this Spencer book. Oh, yeah, but how do we know?
I will give you everything. What you said?
I will give you the language. I will give you origin of language.
Brother.
Oh, how do we know?
Brother.
It doesn't matter what I give you. You're not going to accept it. So let's stop the argument.
Because you told me something, you said...
Let's stop it.
It doesn't matter what I give you, bro. You said you're a European and you said people that you criticize. You insult the European white man. It doesn't matter what I give you.
You are not going to accept it because it does not exist.
Because you don't realize, brother, you make
your Quran. You are not going to accept it. You can't accept it. You cannot accept it. You can't bring yourself to accept it.
Put the Quran aside. I don't do that. Is that argument I'm saying? You just see all your contradictory argument. Yeah. You said to me the white man is our children,
you're
brother.
You're tiring me out now.
You can't empower me. Well, like I said, you're a black man. You should be telling these people they are your children. Yeah. And he said to me, go back and ask the children for the eugenics. You didn't realize how
like
serious that sound, brother.
We already knew we were first. Our monuments are oldest. We already knew we're first. We don't have to even go to him. But I'm saying, to you,
you know,
if you want, if
you want, you know my sit and tone, who's underneath the earth right now?
Shit. Yeah,
yeah, you know how many?
Don't worry about it.
You know many city that's on the top?
I'm tired.
On earth?
I'm tired. I'm tired, bro. I'm tired.
You know how many cities on the earth?
Bro, I'm tired.
I have to be ready.
I'm tired.
You know,
I've never seen a black man fight so hard for a master's religion like you.
No, no.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
Brother,
I've
brother.
Never seen one.
But the thing is,
you're tiring me out, bro.
Thing is, brother.
You are the original and you're fighting for a master's religion like
this. A master religion? Who's the master?
You're Arab master.
My creator was not a man. That's different.
You're Arab master.
Who's Arab?
You're Arab master.
Do you know the people? Arab.
Wait. He's saying the original man is black.
What
does the Quran say?
Brother,
how was Adam made?
If I listen to Arab,
how
believe
was Adam
me.
Made?
You have black Arab from generation of the Arab. You have black
different
Arab.
Places. It's a mix.
You have black Arab.
Where was the angel?
You have black Arab. What part is there? Your master. You take the religion from. You tell me. Are you a brand?
Sticky.
A Spencer.
Sticky.
You tell me a slave master. Let me get the religion from.
I'm not gonna lie, I've tuned out, I've zoned out.
Oh,
I'm not even listening to you anymore.
How come the church hurting?
I've zoned out, bro.
How come the church hurting?
I can't even hear you anymore.
So you contradict yourself?
I can't even hear you.
You want to be the black pride? You don't take information from a white nation then.
I don't take it from
you. Be like, Ali Farrakhan is more different from you at least. He's more different than Ali from you.
You are asking for something.
He put on a line argument, but he stick with his own source rather than Joseph Ben. Usher crazy. They stick with the source where the blacks is getting information from. But you tell me a white man, you're
black. Joseph Ben? Dr. Ben?
Yeah,
go to Dr. Ben. So you know about Dr. Ben, but you're still a Muslim?
No!
You know about Asher Crazy, you're still a Muslim? You know about Asher Crazy and Dr. Ben, you're still a Muslim? Wow.
That's it.
Wow.
Many nations of Islam know about them as well. They read their works as well, they're still Muslim.
So when you read Dr. Ben's works and Asher Crazy's works, how can you still be Muslim? How?
Asher Crazy.
You know why? Because when you're locked inside that book, no evidence. If you can read Dr. Ben and you can read Asher Crazy and listen to their lectures, and you are still not convinced by them, that's how I know nothing ain't gonna convince you, bro. Nothing's gonna convince you. Dr. Ben can't convince you.
Brother, listen. Brother, before Islam, we know the works before Islam. We didn't know nothing about Islam. We know the works before Islam. We sit in person in Birmingham, Asher Kiscom, in Raleigh Range, in Birmingham right there in Antwerp, and we hosted him. And after hosting them, we refute. Then among certain individuals, we refute it because the same thing, the venom that he spits.
You refute Asher Crazy?
Many individuals in the area refuted him because what? But you can't tell me to see a little white child is hating that child and kill him.
Who's talking about hating and killing?
You can't tell me that.
No, no one's talking about
hating. That's what they promote, brother. I know them. I see them in person, brother, in Birmingham. So, I see them in person, brother.
When have you ever heard Asher Crazy to kill white children? When have you ever heard Asher Crazy say that?
White hatred. White.
Oh, come on, man. Stop being stupid. You're being emotional now. I zoned out a long time ago, bro.
I know his name. I know them. I listen.
This man talking about Asher Crazy tells people to kill children.
Based on skin color.
Bro, he's mad. I don't understand. Asher Crazy.
When you start looking to the works?
Maybe Seti or the Hebrew
Israelites.
When did you start looking to the works? When?
Well, Asher Crazy?
Yeah, when did you start?
About 15 years
ago. Sarah, before the battery goes. Sarah.
Wait, let's end this one.
You know how many followers they lose, brother?
I'm tired. You look tired.
You know how many followers they lose? You know how many? Thousands.
Huh?
You know how many thousands of followers they lose? Why? His rating's gone down now. Asher Crazy and this people. You know how many followers they lose? When it's put down chip to Kemet to Egypt.
It's not about followers though.
Sorry.
Yeah? Is it about followers? Is it about numbers? Or is
I'm
it,
saying.
Or is it about facts?
Sorry.
People
fuck.
Don't like the facts.
No, but if you got
so to it's not about numbers,
if
bro.
If you got to promote me, got to kill white people.
Who's promoting that?
To see more videos like this, subscribe to Titans TV down below. Thanks.
The greatest darky, they bite with shark teeth and hate malarkey.
Who you?
The greatest heartbeat, ancient Egypt and the matriarchy.
Who me?
The one with the S on his chest when the motherfucker go by.
Who you?
The one everybody calls your highness, cause the weed got you feeling so high.